Small town grocery stores have faced challenge after challenge in the last few years. Competition, a pandemic, staffing shortages, and now inflation. All of those things have forced many to close, and it's getting worse. A recent survey from the U found that 80% of rural grocery store owners have no succession plan, and nearly half of them expect to close in the next 5 years. But a new kind of store is giving some hope. The store in Evansville is aiming to change the trend by embracing self-service. Here's Kent.
In a small town with limited resources, Evansville's Main Street Market limited its staff hours to just 3 days a week to the general public. But to members, there's unlimited access with the tap of a key fob or a cell phone.
I have an app on my phone, and all I do is touch it to here, and it unlocks the door and lets me in 24 hours a day.
Once inside, they can also use their phones to scan items.
That's it.
And check out in the aisle.
I can either scan another item or I can just pay with card.
Or they can use a self-service register.
Put your card in and perfect. All done.
Dan Evavold's family owns the hardware store next door and appreciates his new neighbors, even if he hardly sees them.
It's just so handy for me. I mean, I don't have to drive 20, 30, 40, 50 miles to buy a loaf of bread or a can of soup. I can just walk next door.
That's been quite a ride.
Kayleen Austinson says her husband, Alex, was the driving force behind the concept.
The grocery store that was in town closed up a few years back, and he came to me one day and said, we need to open a grocery store in Evansville.
Did you have experience opening grocery stores in small towns?
No. Oh, no. Actually, my background is in diesel mechanics, but my strong suit is problem solving.
So how did you land on this type of model? Because this isn't something that's happening in small towns. Amazon's doing this type of stuff in big cities.
For a small community, it's really tough to either be able to staff it 7 days a week or for the owners to staff it. And we just didn't see that as a very sustainable model going forward.
So instead, they built a store focused on stocking the essentials while blending new technology and old school input to serve their community when it's convenient for them.
In our community, we have a lot of people that commute for work. They commute to Alexandria or elsewhere. So they don't get home until, 6 o'clock at night, till after those traditional hours. So it really opens up access to more people.
People might be wondering about theft.
That's usually the first question that's asked.
We know who's coming and going. We know our door log. We know exactly who's coming in. We know who's exactly checking out and what they're getting. So if we ever have any question, it's pretty easy to narrow it down.
It's certainly working. They've grown from 50 to 120 monthly members in the last year, and the products they carry have grown to include local coffee, honey, and even seasonal flowers and produce from local sources.
It's been a neat way to help kind of be a support and give some extra stuff back to the community that way too.
And because they save money on staffing, prices here are more competitive than most expect.
We really want to try to break the stereotype of, oh, it's a small town grocery, it has to be crazy expensive.
And at a time when so many others are burning out and closing down, they're breaking ownership stereotypes too.
We have a couple young kids and they keep us pretty busy too. So we were looking at how we can make this more sustainable for one, but also to find a good work-life balance.
For our community, it's worked great so far.
This self-service model could be coming to other Minnesota main streets soon. The Austinsons say they've consulted with other small town groceries looking to make this kind of switch. They're also in talks to open a second, even bigger location in a neighboring town coming soon. In Evansville, Kent Erdahl, Care 11 News.